Some people are incredible human beings who are mentally and physically so special that they earn their place among the select few peak humans that we call astronauts. And others get sick to their stomachs riding in a car, let alone blasting off on a rocket, or heaven forbid, a car on a rocket, which has happened. And sometimes those people are one and the same. Thanks to one woman, though, talented astronauts don't have to be sidelined because their stomachs just can't keep their shrimp cocktail down. Her name is Dr. Patricia Cowings, and she led the development of the autogenic feedback training, or AFT. Your autonomic nervous system controls things that you don't normally think about. Things like your heart rate, breathing, sweating, digestion, that sort of thing. And if you've ever experienced motion sickness, you may notice that these things start to spiral out of control. Dr. Cowings' training teaches astronauts how to control what they usually can't. 50% of astronauts will get motion sickness in space, which makes sense. You're floating, and everything else is floating, and then you're on orbit, and it's moving really fast. Cowings' method achieves this by figuring out where the trainees' resting levels are, and then strapping them into a rotating chair that spins the bejesus out of them. Once Cowings knows how stress affects the trainee, she teaches them autogenic therapy techniques that focus their attention on something like the sensation in their fingertips. Trainees are taught to focus so well that they don't pay attention to anything else, like, for example, the room spinning round and round. By changing their reaction to stress, trainees can keep over 24 bodily functions in check and keep their lunch down. The AFT method is actually something that you could learn too, sort of. It's basic operant conditioning. Think Pavlov's dogs that were trained to salivate at the sound of a bell. You can train humans to control their heart rate. All you have to do, says Dr. Cowings' paper on the topic, is remove the blindfold, or essentially teach yourself to perceive your heart rate, your stress level, and so on. Astronauts were put in a rotating chair that rotated at a different speed from the walls of the room, which were going the opposite direction. And they asked them to assess their stress level and autonomic functions every 5 minutes. Over just a few hours with the right reinforcement, they learned to understand their responses and control them. The uses go beyond preventing a mess inside your space helmet as well. Astronauts can use these techniques to help them perform better in stressful situations or sleep better in microgravity. And amazingly, training only takes 6 hours over the course of about 3 weeks. Dr. Cowings' work helps astronauts prepare for the rigors of space, something very few of us could probably imagine. Not Dr. Cowings, though, because before developing this training for astronauts, she actually went through the rigmarole herself and holds the distinction of being not just the first African-American woman to receive astronaut scientist training, she was the first American woman trained, full stop. Dr. Cowings has been contributing science at NASA for years, and we're happy to celebrate her achievements for Black History Month. If you think this channel has the right stuff, you should probably subscribe. You think you have what it takes to be an astronaut? Check out Julian's video here to find out. Not only is Dr. Cowings' work helping our astronauts, it's also helping our soldiers too. The US Army uses it to evaluate how their vehicles affect soldiers to help them keep combat ready and not get motion sick. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Seeker.